Hi, I'm James. Here's a travisher that I unpacked recently. This is a brand new travisher with a blade just set. And this is an English double bow Windsor chair seat. And I have roughed it out using an Arbitech industrial blade on an angle grinder. So it's now ready for the travisher. I've done the hogging out. I could have done that with an adze, but for less effort and a lot less time, the Arbitech is a great tool. So, using the travisher, I've got to get this travisher going on the roughest possible surface, but I'll give you a little tip just to get it going easily in any situation. That goes on the wood, and the travisher wants to work across the grain. It works much better across the grain than with the grain, so it's a really unusual tool. To get it going the first time, hands go lightly on top, thumbs just behind the blade. And to begin with, lift the blade up off the wood. So really exaggerate it, so it's just rubbing on the wooden nose in front of the blade, like so. Then get a little rhythm going, backwards and forwards, like this. Holding the tool quite lightly. And then as you're going backwards and forwards, just drop the blade slowly down until it starts to engage. I think that's a smoother bit. I'm going to try here. So backwards and forwards without the blade, gradually dropping it. Here we go, and it's beginning to engage. And just to show you how lightly you need to hold the tool, I'll just do it with four fingertips. Hopefully you can hear a swishing sound. And when you get that swish of when it's cutting, you know that it's going really well. So this bit is now fairly smooth. I'll just do a little bit more out here. Doing that, I'll smooth out this side and then turn it around and come in the other direction. So I think that gives you the idea of how the tool works. I'd probably like to set that just a little bit coarser, then I can get the wood to come off a little bit faster. And let's do that, just lift it up a little bit. Again, don't over tighten those grub screws. Working really kindly, but sometimes it will judder, in which case you've just got to skew the tool one way or another. Usually on this side you skew it this way, so I'm going in that direction, like so, and then on this side you skew it that way to make it cut cleanly on that side. There is always a way that will work, it's just a matter of experimenting. And it's a nice tool to use, one of my favourite bits of Windsor chair making. Thank you, goodbye.